A common question we get in the winter is, how do you guys fish for lake trout in the Boundary Waters? This is our setup. All of this stuff fits into this pack here with room to spare. And I will show you guys what we bring. First things first, rods. Got a collection of rods here. One spinning rod and two bait casters. I really like the bait casters in the winter. They hold a lot of line. They deal with line twist better than spinning rods, I think. And they deal with the cold real well too. This is a, let's say, got two St. Croix medium heavy rods. I think those are 34 inch. And then that's an ugly stick. It is a 28 inch walleye rod. That's a Shimano Saris. There's a Ryobi V-Mag in there, and then the ubiquitous Abu Garcia Ambassador. As far as lures, what you'll see here is, this is my all-time favorite lake trout lure. This is a Northland Buckshot Spoon. I love these. They rattle, they sink real well. They've always been great for me. They make a bunch of different sizes of them. Get that to focus. They make a bunch of different sizes of them, and great colors for lake trout. We've also got the classic bucktail jig. This is another Northland bucktail jig. It's got a single hook. Remember, when you have those single hooks fishing for lake trout, you want to keep them real sharp. Those trout have real sharp, tough jaws. Big trout especially. It's all bone. This is my second favorite lake trout lure. This is a a spinning jig. I don't know what they're called. It's got a little propeller on it with a lead head. These are awesome. Tipped with a minnow. Everything with a minnow. Another tip for ice fishing, especially if you're vertical jigging a lot, is swivel. That's a barrel swivel. About 3 feet up the line between the lure and the rest of the line that goes to the reel. It really helps a lot when you got a jig like that, that will twist your line quite a bit. Tip-ups. There's nothing special about these tip-ups. They're tip-ups. They've got 12-pound mono leaders on them. Just like all this, this is 12-pound mono. I use all sorts of different line. Fire Line, Power Pro. Right now I just happen to have 12-pound mono and everything. Works real well. One thing to keep in mind, if you're coming up here to fish for lake trout in deep water, which is a lot of lake trout fishing, make sure you got plenty of Dacron on there. You want to make sure that if you have a tip-up set in 60 feet of water and a fish takes it and runs, that you don't run out of line. And make sure that you have a good knot tied to your spool, because you would not want to pull this tip-up up and have a totally empty spool with no fish. Ice scoops. I bring a lot of ice scoops. One sits in the middle bucket, and then two float around for scooping ice out of holes here and there. I don't like to bring just one, because then you're always looking for it, or if you're fishing with a couple people, someone else always has it and you need to walk over and get it from them. Little tackle box. I don't bring a ton of tackle when I fish. I kind of know what I like and what works. Those three lures I have over here on these rods, I use these 99% of the time. If you threw on an airplane jig, those would probably be the four lures that I use almost every single time I fish for lake trout up here in the winter. A map. Of course, anytime you go anywhere outside, you should have a map with you. There's a lot of great maps of the lake trout lakes up here. The depth lines, the contour lines, are not always accurate. That's why you always got to have the flasher. This is a Markham LX5. I love it. And it's almost a necessity, I think, when fishing for lake trout through the ice. More times than I can count, I've been in 50 feet of water, jigging right on the bottom, and then I've seen a mark come in at 20 feet, reel up to it, boom, got the fish. GPS. I use the GPS to fish almost every time I go. I've got dozens and dozens of points marked in it. It's an essential thing. If you're going to fish a lake a lot, you can really pinpoint where to fish. And when you find that secret reef that no one knows about, you can mark it and always come back to it. Always got to have the camera. You never know when you want to take a video or a picture of your nice fish. Coffee pot. Always like to have hot coffee out there. Have a fire on shore, watch the tip-ups, have some food, some hot coffee. I keep matches, coffee, and a cups in the pot when we're out there. Auger. It's a hand auger. I've got a power auger for when we fish outside the boundary waters, but I don't bring it all the time simply because it's heavy and kind of a pain, and if it doesn't work, then you're really in trouble. This is a Nils hand auger. They're awesome. They cut better than any other hand auger, but they are heavier and longer, a little more to carry if you're hiking a long ways into the boundary waters to fish. Cooler. You're probably wondering, what is this little blue cooler doing here? This is where I keep minnows. I get my minnows at Buck's in town in a bag, get a couple dozen chubs, and I put the whole bag right into the cooler and then let some of the air out so I can close the lid, lock it, and put it in the pack. And your minnows won't freeze, they're well protected, and they'll stay alive for days if you change the water in the cooler. Even if you're camping out there, keeping your minnows in a cooler is really essential. If you're going to camp for a few days out in the woods, bring a nice cooler, keep the minnows in there, change the water. Them swimming around in the water will keep it from freezing. And then you can bring it in the tent at night, and that'll go farther in keeping your minnows alive, keeping them from freezing in there. And it fits perfectly in the pack. In this pack, you will see that there is a cardboard box. And it's about half the size of the pack. And the reason I have it in there is that you can put the rods and the tip-ups and the ice scoops in there, and it keeps them apart from everything else, keeps the rods protected, and keeps everything organized. You don't get hooks and things that shouldn't be hooked, and protects the rods when it's bounced around. This pack, when it's packed, is real nice to carry, but it also fits perfectly in the back of my snowmobile. All right, so that is our setup. I'm going to pack this whole thing up and show you guys what it looks like when it is all ready to go. And here it is. This is our pack, all ready to go. This is a Cook Custom Sewing hybrid guide, I think. Excellent, excellent pack. We rent these here at Tuscarora. They're a fantastic pack for winter camping, for summer camping, anytime you need a great big pack with a great strap system. You see that on the left is the box that I mentioned, full of everything that was on the table, just about everything. The camera, the GPS will be in the pockets. The coffee pot will usually be in a separate little pack stuffed in the top of this with food in it, and the auger will not fit in the pack. So we got the box full of everything that you need to fish. The fish finder is sitting there. The Markham is sitting there on top of the cooler, which is underneath there with the minnows in it. And then I got my map tucked back in there. You'll see there's a lot of room on top. Lunch will be there. Extra clothes will be there. Anything extra that we need to throw in the top of the pack will fit right in there. And then we'll buck it all together, throw it on, or throw it in the back of the snowmobile and go. A lot of people say, why don't you pull a sled? I've never liked pulling sleds unless I'm winter camping and you need to pull a sled. Sleds get stuck in the slush. They're a pain on portages. If they get coated in ice and then they freeze, you're in trouble. You'll be chipping ice away from it. I think it's just not necessary for how little we bring. It's more pain than it's worth.